Here's the deal. We need a lot of protein, probably more than you think. We need that protein every single day. It comes in many different foods and you can get it in a lot of different ways, but something to consider when you're getting your protein is how much does it cost for you to get that protein? Like, are the sources that you're eating your protein from cost effective, or are they just breaking your bank for how much protein they provide you? So I decided to do a little protein study of my own and break down the cost per 30 grams of protein of the most common sources. And so this is what I have for here. This is what I have. So this is what I have for you to, I'll put these down. When I make each person's meal plan, their power plan, I take a lot of things into consideration. And one of them is definitely the cost of your grocery list every week. So it's very important for me to understand how much 30 grams of protein is going to cost before I put them in the meal plan. So that's what I have to share with you. I have one dozen eggs to start with. An average price is $2.50 for a dozen. That's gonna provide you 72 grams of protein, which comes out to $1 for 30 grams of protein. So you're only spending $1 for 30 grams of protein. That is the least expensive out of all my protein options that I found. So some drawbacks or other considerations: when you're buying eggs, you're also going to need to cook them. You're either gonna hard boil them or, you know, scramble, so that's going to take time to prepare them. You're also going to get fat when you buy eggs, so things to consider. Ascent Protein, that's my favorite protein powder. It costs $42 a bag for 675 grams of protein. It comes out to $1.85 per 30 grams of protein. I love protein powder because it's super convenient. I have a protein shake in everyone's meal plan every week because of the convenience and because of the cost, and this is a very high quality protein. Other things to consider about a protein powder, most of them are just straight up protein. There's not very many carbs or many fat, and this one's very clean. If you go less clean, it can be even less expensive than that. So it's really, like, protein powder is not a super expensive option to get all your protein in, so I like it. 1 pound grass-fed beef. I put grass-fed in there because I do not recommend you eat any beef that's not grass-fed. It's way different, so I'm not even gonna talk about cheap beef. Grass-fed beef, on average, is $9 a pound. That's gonna give you 88 grams of protein, and that comes out to $3 for 30 grams of protein. In my study, that is the most expensive source of protein, but if you're getting grass-fed, you are getting other benefits than just straight-up protein. Also, something else to consider, you are getting fat as well, and if it's grass-fed, it's healthy fat and it's good for you. So that is also giving to that $3. Next one, organic chicken breasts. It's gonna be an average of $7 per pound. It's gonna give you 104 grams of protein, and it comes out to $2 for 30 grams of protein. Chicken breasts are very low in fat. You don't have to worry about the protein also contributing to your fat for the day. There's no carbs in chicken, so it's pretty much straight up protein, $2 for organic chicken breast for 30 grams. Here's some things that I don't typically put in many meal plans because a lot of our members are dairy free, but when you're thinking about protein, you have to think about dairy. It is a great source of protein, and if you're getting it from a good source, you can feel good about it. So let's go through Vanilla Greek yogurt. The brand I buy is $5 for a carton. It provides me 75 grams of protein, and it comes out to $2 for 30 grams of that protein. So the brand that I buy is Greek, so it's higher in protein than a lot of the traditional yogurts, and it's lower in sugar and carbs. So I like that option. It gives me a little bit of fat, it gives me a little bit of carbs, and it's another option for my protein. Last but not least, Fairlife milk. That is a brand that has a higher protein content than a lot of the other brands of milk. I like the taste of Fairlife milk, and I like that it has higher protein and has lower carbs because of the process that they make it. Fairlife milk, $4 per the way that they sell it in. That provides me 91 grams of protein, which comes out to only $1.30 for 30 grams of protein. So Fairlife milk is an option when you're thinking about protein. It provides you a little bit of carbs, depending on the full fat or low fat that you get. It's It's going to be how much fat is in it. But it's the second least expensive option. First is eggs, then is milk, and this is a high quality milk, and it's very inexpensive for the protein content. Ascent Protein comes out to a really good price. Next is chicken breast, Greek yogurt, and last is beef. Again, we all need protein. We need a lot of protein, at least your body weight a day in grams. And so calculating that all up, you're going to be spending, you know, $6 to $10 probably every day just on protein. And it's smart to know how much it is costing you, and you can make better choices that stick with your budget and what you like to do. You know, sometimes it's nice to make food. Sometimes it's nice to just shake up and drink your protein, or sometimes you want to drink it in a glass of milk or eat some yogurt instead of just, you know, eating eggs. That's what I do in Power Plans. I take a lot of things into consideration creating a yummy meal plan, but not one that's gonna break the bank. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe and like it and watch my other videos. You'll love them.